a sun ray. Started off with it, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick, and she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you a demon. I get the money for real, no reason. White body come through unpolitely. I ride around in anxiety. Wake me up, cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this. I never had no money.
Today, from Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida, it's week 9 of the NFL on EA Sports.
This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. First down, Justin Herbert. Man open, that's Henry Ruggs. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Herbert. The Philip Dorsett hauls it in. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Pretty good start right off the bat there with throws 1 and 2.
He's not locking in on just one target early, is he? Spreading it around a little bit as this game gets started.
Back-to-back first downs. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Here's Herbert. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 21. Herbert throwing the out route and complete. That's Jordan. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. The confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing. Let's keep going.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Henry Ruggs with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Texans take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So that drive, 7 plays in length. And it results in the Texans finding the end zone. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
Noah Igbinoghi from his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of 1 there. Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up 1st and 10
at their own 26. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now a stoppage here as it looks like we've got a Dolphin shaking up on the play. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. On play action, here's Tua. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's 2nd down. Tua gonna throw. Open man left side. It's a tight end long. And he's gonna be out of bounds right at midfield.
So Tua making the completion there. What's different about playing a left-handed quarterback like him? And specifically, I guess, what does this defense need to try and take away?
I'll take the first part that you asked about being left-handed. We've got to find out if he can move to his right and still continue to be accurate. So I want to push him in that direction and see if he can get his body squared around and make those throws that he's used to making. The next part is he's a ball thrower. Love those short to intermediate routes first. Sit on those and make him throw the deep ball. Not that he's not capable, but you want him to prove it to you first.
Third and one, and Tua wants to throw it. Steps away to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Looking to pass. Tua. On the right side, open is Gesicki. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get it.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Malik Collins. He's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up 4 last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, their quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games. I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback, but when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
We'll drop this one down to Freeman. And they'll hustle up to stop him well shy of the first, right around the 15. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Sanders' kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. On first down, it's Herbert. Throw complete right side to Cooks. The 20. Touchdown, Houston. Brandon Cooks. His 6th touchdown of this. And the Texans are able to show off their quick strike ability. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for 6. Igbinoghene elects not to return it. The football will come out to the 25-yard line. So Miami coming out for their 2nd drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. A very uneven start is certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the nautical side, I'm going to try and keep up here because, to me, this ship is about games are absolute must wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5, maybe they start believing in themselves. But a loss here, that would move them to 3-6. And if they to the harbor with them still on the dock.
On first and 10. Over the middle, he's got
the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're me a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up a two.
And the Texans say they have it. They do. Every week we hear talk about create turnovers. In particular, they wanted to force some fumbles. They got one right there.
And it shows you how the game has changed over time. It used to be good enough for a guy to get a sack of a quarterback in the pocket. Now, if you come to the sidelines and you didn't knock the ball free,
you're touchdown, Texans! Henry Ruggs with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Texans are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. They certainly made quick work of that, ultra quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see. Just one play resulting in the touchdown. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Now the throw going to Fuller, and he's got it. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. He's got long, his tight end complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
All teams that don't normally press, you put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half. To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Throwing again on second and 10. Tua, he'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Out of the gun, they give to Freeman. Yeah, Freeman was trying to work his way forward, but I don't think he got there. Loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. So on fourth down, the Dolphins' new punter for 2021, Michael Pilardi, on to punt. As he's on to punt for the first time, that's just outside the 20-yard line. The Texans' offense ready to go here for their next drive. 4-4, their record through 8 games on the season. Would you say that this team has overperformed, underperformed, or are they kind of right where you thought that they would be?
Do you mind if I say yes? Yes and yes, because ultimately to me, 4-4 is about where they should be, because we've seen weeks where they've been really, really good. They've looked terrific. Other weeks where we've wondered just how good is this team. They want to be consistent in their play, not consistently inconsistent, which is what they've been thus far.
Throwing again on second down. Herbert looking for Ruggs again, and he's got him again. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play that time through the air, 35 yards. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Back to throw here, Herbert. Being chased out left. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Dolphins will take over here at their own 12-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And with a three-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. Here's second and 10. From the gun, it's Tua. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's long. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Out of the gun on third down, here's Tua. Got a man. It's the rookie, Jalen Waddle. And they are into field goal range now as he's got the first down at the 26. It's been a very one-sided game so far. They got to change what they're doing right now, don't they? You can't wait till the halftime speech to make an adjustment.
No, you can't, because if you're doing it right, you're adjusting from series to series, and they need a big adjustment here to try to put some points on the board.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. Down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. Igbinoghini elects not to return, and the football will come out to the 25-yard line. The Dolphins getting set to go back to work here in quarter number three. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball to the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
They go to Freeman again on second down. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Liam Eichenberg, second-round pick in 2021 from Notre Dame, the guilty party. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And over the middle, this is Parker. And that's good for a gain of six. And they're going to have a third down. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Now Tua. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. Flush to his right. And Tua going to slide to a halt, but he will have the first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. To a hit, and the ball is out. But I think a Dolphin was able to fall on it. Yes, they'll keep possession here. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. From the gun, it's a run for Freeman. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. Tua sets up to pass it. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. A gain of 8 there on the play, and it'll be 4th down. Tua on 4th down. Got his man. It's the tight end long. Touchdown! Hunter Long. His second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead as they score on the opening drive of the second half. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie. Because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. On the return, Tremont Smith. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
And you can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Herbert on first down now. Eluding the pressure right. This one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's 2nd down. 3rd quarter from Miami. This is 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, Herbert. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that is caught. But he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. It's complete to Chris Conley. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. Herbert back to the air. Flushed out right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Well, they've got it down to the 3, but now this is 3rd and goal. Now it's Herbert. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on 3rd and goal. Let's see what they do on 4th and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on 4th and goal. So they've got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
So 3 points, response there to that opening touchdown in this 3rd quarter.
And that's an important 3, both in terms of adding to your lead, but also letting the other guys know you're not going to just come out in the second half and take over.
Igbinoghi elects not to return, and the football will come out to the 25-yard line. Miami set to take over. And that last touchdown drive, a good mix of pass and run. Defensively, they just looked a little out of whack.
And it's so hard to stay up with an offense that has things going so well where you're guessing and guessing wrong play after play. So what you need is someone on the defensive side of the ball
leader, right?
To make a big play. Throw that balance out of whack. That's what you're looking for now. Not worrying so much about guessing what the play call is.
On second down, Freeman. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Tua. Throw right side into the hands of the tight end Long. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. From the 44, Tua. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. You know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call
two-a-hit, and the ball is out. And the Texans scoop it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Eric Rowe. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Looking to throw again on second down. Tua.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Tua now on first down. And he's got his man on the out route. And out of bounds right around the 20. Under four to go now as they come up on second down. And again, it's Tagovailoa. Gets it off to Freeman. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They'll look to throw again. Steps away. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down. He'll drop to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Desmond King picks it. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. In the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
Freeman. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. Devontae Freeman, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Houston's offense taking over again. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball. Said, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Second and 10. Here's Herbert once more. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. And they're going to speed things up here. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. Reception here by Ruggs. And some room to run now. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Herbert throwing again. Escaping the pressure right. He's got Jordan complete right side. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. To throw again on second down. Herbert. And he will find his man Ruggs. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. David Johnson, his 3rd touchdown now on the year.
And the Texans are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this 4th quarter lead.
Fairbairn good with the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
Igbinoghi going to take it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Passing lanes, tough to come by with so many defensive backs on the field here late in the game.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Justin Reed. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his 2nd year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, 2nd year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10.
Here's Johnson. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame.
2nd down and 5.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining.
The heavy set out there. 3 tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert on the move to his left. Dumping it off for Johnson.
And the Texans are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
With the late lead, Herbert's going to throw it. And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston.
Brevin Jordan.
His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Texans use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. 5 plays there on that drive. And the result, a Houston touchdown.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. Now back to throw. Able to find Gesicki as tight end. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Calling a gain of six on the play. And that'll make it second down. And that one drops to the ground. Incomplete. Clock stops here just inside of 20 seconds. 19 left. Tua gonna throw. Now a short one to Gesicki. And he is gonna have the Dolphins first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting seven there on third and four. Open net is Waddle complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.